So she learned by this how the evil spell might be broken, and she carefully sprinkled every stone till there was not one left, only a great company of youths and girls who followed her down the mountain. When they arrived at the palace, she did not lose a moment in planting the branch of the Tree of Beauty and watering it with the water of life. And the branch shot up into a tree and was heavy with flowers, and the talking bird nestled in its branches. Now the fame of these wonders was noised abroad, and the people flocked in great numbers to see the three marvels and the maiden who had won them. And among the sightseers came the king's son, who would not go till everything was shown him, until he had heard how it had all happened. And the prince admired the strangeness and the beauty of the treasures in the palace, but more than all, he admired the beauty and courage of the maiden who had brought them there. So he went home and told his parents, and gained their consent to wed her for his wife. And then the marriage was celebrated in the church adjoining the palace. And then the bridegroom took her to his own home, where they lived happy forever after. The Wounded Lion. There was once a girl so poor that she had nothing to live on and wandered about the world asking for charity. One day she arrived at a thatched cottage and inquired if they could give her any work. The farmer said he wanted a cowherd, as his own had left him, and if the girl liked the place she might take it. So she became a cowherd. One morning she was driving her cows through the meadows when she heard nearby a loud groan that almost sounded human.